Hey everyone, welcome back to base making part two. As you follow along and watch us build a very simple base upon which to display any kind of model, really. Let me walk you through some of the preliminary tools and materials you are going to need for this. And I also want to talk a little bit about options and variety if you don't have these things, okay? We are going to begin with a spatula. These are our handy dandy spatulas we've had for a long time. They're both very flexible. The only difference is that this one is made out of metal and it has a different shape than this one. This one has served us well for a bunch of years. This is plastic and it's good for stirring and mixing, but anything will work. You know, a piece of an old credit card, a piece of cardboard, a tonsil checking little piece of wood thingy, you know, not a tonsil, but a tongue depressor. There you go. But they use them for checking tonsils and things like that. But we're not that kind of doctor here. Little containers that you can get basically for free if you frequent restaurants that let you take home salsas and sauces and stuff like that, or save the stuff that you buy your food in and keep it around. We also have ceramic little bowls here, and you know, that's fine. You know, you don't have to be fancy. The other thing that you are going to need is a good acrylic. You know, craft store acrylics will do. What I mean by good is you know, a good solid dark color. Okay, and in this case, we use in our art we use a lot of golden, but golden is very expensive. But we have this tub here of Van Dyke brown, and you could use black as well. But we like this brown because it's very dark, but not black, and it's going to serve to tint our the material that we're using to put on our base. Okay, and we're going to apply it with our handy dandy spatula. Okay, so the material, of course, in this case is Basics coarse texture gel, which we love, and absolutely fantastic. But it comes in white, and it's acrylic, of course, and it does say use with acrylic paint. And you know, when they give you instructions like that, you're supposed to follow them for the most part. But I would imagine you can also tint this with food coloring, but we never do that. We just use acrylic paint, cheap or expensive, it doesn't matter. But for this kind of stuff, I would say cheap is better than expensive. All right. So you're going to need this texture gel. Now, what happens if you don't have texture gel? Well, we're going to send you to play in the mud, my friends. You can take some white glue, unthinned, okay, and you can drop it into your container here. And then you can add dirt or sand and make your own goopy concoction. Now, if you're using dark earth, you're really not going to need to tint it, but you know, we're trying not to play too much with stuff that'll get on everything and kind of ruin our the laboratory surface, since the laboratory is so beautiful, right? But you can mix your own. If you don't have texture gel, fine grain sand and white glue will do. See, that rhymes. Good poetry. So, you know, in the next video, I am going to show you how to mix it, prepare it, and then apply it. And you're going to see how easy it is. And then we'll go from there. I don't suspect this is going to be a long process, so there'll be a few more videos, but probably not that many. All right, so do stay tuned in for part 3 coming right up, my friends.